is about to get nasty up in here. You just go ahead and
do that.
Do you think it's gonna kill him? What do you guys think?
Hey guys, if you're looking for the best decks, meta guides, or matchup tables, check out my website, masteringroterra.com. There's also a subscription option that gets you a 2-hour weekly learning call, premium articles, and a lot more if you're looking to take your game to the next level. Now back to the video.
Because my all-time favorite hero, Alan, plays for Liquid. World champion. Karma lover extraordinaire. This matchup sucks. I really like Core JJ. So my brother bought me this like 3 years ago. Almost 4 years ago now. Yeah, it was pre-COVID, so it was 4 years ago he bought me this. And it says Majin Bay on the back. This was like before I started streaming or anything. Hello. These are not the cards we want. Lingerbox owns TL? No, he does not. Slip through my paws! Guy named Steve owns TL. At least he runs it. There's a bunch of like investors and stuff, right? Do I have Telstones? One. I have one Telstone.
We each hold a world within.
Like TL back when they were profitable. So never, man. You must not like any esports org then. Not a single one of those guys are profitable. And draw. Damn, that's good. We're just gonna like play out our stuff. We just need to just get there.
Sounds dangerous. I'm in.
100T. 100T is not profitable as an esports org. It's profitable because they have a bunch of really, really well-known creators. Like, if they dumped the esports stuff, then they'd be, like, raking it. And I imagine that's what, like, everyone will do.
I long for the day when this is
over. You know what I'm saying? Diversify your revenue streams. One of them's a revenue stream, and one of them's a money pit. Hungerbox's co-owner? Oh, I actually did not know that.
Tyrus, you left me alone.
Hiya! Die. That's pretty nice. If our opponent plays another shard, I'll health pot I.
The spirit gives to those who
son of a bitch. I'm still gonna health pot I. Just to get the Dragonling. Took your advice, got Amazon Kindle, now I'm book 11 of Unsold. Let's go. Cradle's goated, man. Unironically, you're a Fnatic fan. You were. I don't watch League anymore, so I can't like really call myself a fan at all. Damn, I guess I'm just coming in with Ezreal, huh? That's a nice little draw. I'll just fire that bad boy off right now, huh? We could get like homecoming, so I probably should have just opened with Ezreal. That was a mistake. I played enough Ryze. I know how to play against this. Why am I playing so bad? Will needs to give you a kickback. I know, man. I promoted that guy's books more than he has.
Man will
always fight. God damn. Where's Tyrus to leave him alone again?
It's not bragging if you could back it up. Firing.
Quinn. I think this pass is decent for me, though. Okay, I'll let you out. I'll let you out.
I hear you.
Incoming Quinn.
Oh,
another demon. So then we open.
Watch and learn.
I guess we could play Sky Singer now. Boo. Boo. Yep.
Arrogance plagues us.
The good one.
And ours.
His and ours. Sure.
It's not bragging if you can back it up.
I don't need Eye of the Dragons. It's not going to do anything. Let's get imbalanced here. Stunned. Sure. Please no more dubs. Please no more dubs. I need one more turn. Okay. I think we might be in the clear. Not like in the clear, but like, you know what I mean. Ugh, gross.
They did not know. How could they? I cannot stand by in the face of apocalypse!
Ionia speaks through me.
You gonna bounce her? Mm-hmm. I should have waited until like post-combat for that. Oh no, boo!
Let's go! I warned you!
Obstacle. Fortunately, we lose Ezreal. It is our only Ezreal. There goes our easy dub. Easy. Okay. Pass the turn. We don't have a deny. Unfortunately.
Desperation begets folly.
I also don't have a bounce.
None are more desperate than Viego.
Enough, you're desperate.
Enough! This cannot stand.
That's not a bounce spell. Not looking very good. It was almost looking really, really good.
We'll bring peace to Ionia, whatever the cost.
Ah, another one. It's one mana. Fuck you. Out of unworthies, but there's still three homecomings.
Bet.
Now you will understand. Did they find the third rise? Because that would suck.
Come on, Amps Live, let's go.
They have a shitload of cards in their deck. Mm-hmm. This means no rise this turn. Which I'm not going to say means we win, but it puts us in a very, very good spot. Very good spot. Need that one Ezreal? Nah, we're fine. Karma's you dual cast concussive. If our opponent opens with rise, then you have to stack these two. You can't play Karma. If I'm given the opportunity to, I will play Karma. Because I really just want to like cast stuff. Okay, that's fine. Don't think I can afford to cast this.
Power
okay.
Changes everyone.
Well, that makes that decision
enough.
For us, isn't it?
This cannot
in it.
Stand.
A little bit of that. A 2-mana homecoming. How much does this... Does Seraphine copy this as well? No. So we go like this. But if they 2-mana homecoming and replay Rise, we kill him with Quadruple Mystic. We're not able to fill the stack here. Ah, oh, yeah, that'll do it. Oh, no, it's not 2-mana, though, so we're fine. Or do I just rip it right now? Fill the stack and kill the Rise, right? And now it's game over? Oh, we're one short of filling the stack. Okay. But this is the last Rise. Yeah, let's go, baby, let's go. Nope is kind of bad. Well, Nope's all right, because then we just play Karma again on our turn, right? And then we can like, and then we can do all the stuff. Woo! Let's go. There's some decks that I enjoy right now. I really like to play this one. I really like to play the Tibble deck. Is that a Noxus Jace Heimer? Sturdy HP Nexus this week. I think it's Infinite Champs. And if you're not playing Rise in 30 HP Nexus, you are doing it wrong. I think Rise in 30 HP Nexus is about to be the most busted deck that's ever existed in any format. Double up Decimate? Yeah, but like Shock Blast is big. I guess you just run like 3 Shock Blast, 3 Decimate. 1 hour games? Nah, it won't be that long because you're just gonna die. You're just gonna be dead.
Lyrics just aren't coming to me. Time to find a muse.
Zirelia might be pretty good at 30 HP. Maybe. Maybe.
I fight with my spirit, not my fists.
Oh, is that for me, Nugget?
Okay, let's get, let's just get Eye of the Dragon going. We'll activate Flow. I was talking about Rise 30 HP, but nobody's talking about Star Spring at 30 HP. Sorry, Puh. But I don't think your Star Spring deck's gonna beat Rise either. What'd be cool is a 10 HP mode? I want you to think about what that would look like. For like a second. Just ruminate on it in your mind.
Suppose you want us
now
work,
to play Karma.
Right?
Well, that is what I pay you for.
Or what? It's literally just burn spells. It's burn spells and one drops. That's the meta. Pass. You have more mana. Pirates meta? Pirates would be too slow. No, thank you. What would hard counter rise at 30 HP? Nothing. Nothing. Literally nothing. Oh. Like the Annie S cat video? Yeah, that's one of my favorite decks.
This is the cutting edge of progress.
So I'm gonna shoot him. So anyway, I started blasting.
Will do, Axel. Replicating the power spike.
That's a lot of cards. Over 9,000. MM Guigo! Thank you for the prime in the 4 months. Again, probably butchered it. Sorry. But thank you for the sub. I appreciate that. Go Karma? Hell yeah. We got two Karmas on board. It's even better than one.
Yeah, yeah.
If we do this, we take our lumps, but we trigger flow, so next turn we get to attack with a bunch of dragonlings and stuff. What do we have here? 5? Okay, could be decent. Another hex splitter right here.
It's an awesome day for progress.
Mm-hmm. So I don't have flow. Steel tip is just kind of nice. Palm or something off the top would be good. Any draw spell. There we go. Yeah. No thanks.
No.
No.
Love to. Your lesson begins.
Just cast a bunch of cards, right? Did I draft the new set? No, I played two pre-releases. I have draft tomorrow. Did you draft it? Is it sick? It seems like the sickest draft format. It's lit? Yeah. We're talking about Flesh and Blood for those not following. It seems like the most insane draft format. I enjoyed the sealed too. Sure. Okay, so next turn we get to double up Deep Man if we want to, which is pretty good.
Heart and mind as one.
Five drafts so far? Sheesh! Yeah, we haven't gotten the product yet. I'm just gonna cast that.
I hear you, Zahn.
What have you
now
been enjoying?
You're about to hear me.
Online only? Okay. I have been trying very hard not to focus on Flesh and Blood at all because I have the Battle Spirit Saga launch event this weekend. She's being the left. They fixed it. They fixed that. God, I love Glorious Evolution. You know what's even better than one Glorious Evolution? Two Glorious Evolutions. Sure. Any thoughts on BSS? Looked interesting. Wow, the game wants me to play Poggers Day so bad. I've drawn, like, so I drew my Piltover Tailstones. I created one. And then when that wasn't, like, when that was too subtle for them, they just created me a Poggers Day as well. Just to make sure I got the message. I can also, like, I can retreat return Karma. And if you want to hear my thoughts on Battle Spirit Saga, I go into depth in it on yesterday's stream.
You see, but you cannot grasp.
This is gross. Sure. How many cards do I have? Let me just go ahead and
I do that.
As water.
Yeah, why not? Eventually I'll find a kitty. Yeah. That was fun. That was fun. Whoa. Victor Yee. This is actually probably going to be really tough for us. So we won't be very good. Like, they'll actually be able to put a clock on us. And then, like, having to play around denies and stuff and bump spells is going to be difficult.
I don't do meditation.
The crystal! Wu Ting style!
Hey, I won of. My fun of.
I fight with my spirit, not my fists.
The new card's karma works with coins? I believe so. I mean, I think that's how it works.
It's over 9,000.
I'm not sure. Lunatic Sandwich, think of the Prime. Excited for the possible new Noxus Ionia synergies in the next LOR expansion? Yeah, that'll be interesting because we haven't really had like a good Noxus Ionia deck basically ever. And I know some of you in chat are about to like yell out decks and stuff. You're going to be like, what about this deck? What about this deck? And I'll have to be like, that deck sucked. Alan asked Ruben, Karma doubles mana. Oh my God, that's so awesome. I'm so excited. Yasuo Katarina, Seasonals winner. I stand by, that was not a very good deck. I think Yasuo Katarina, even in that meta, was not a good deck. It was just very good at exploiting the tournament metagame. Oh, that's nice. Does that not make it a good deck? Not necessarily, no. Like,
the spirit gives to those who listen.
When it's Duckling won with like Big Cithria, like Matron Cithria, that deck wasn't a good deck. But it worked really well for the field. Sidner, thank you for the 14 months. Like, if you weren't allowed a ban and things like that, and you the deck wouldn't have nearly the excess it the success it had in open rounds of seasonals as it did in top 32. I'm a shooter. Don't expect this to work, but I'm still gonna do it. 14 months, goddamn. Seems like semantics. Are you referring to a good deck as one that is generally good in a casual or ladder format? I'm referring to a good deck as a deck that just is very strong on its own in a vacuum. And I don't think Noxus Ionia has ever had one. Evaluate decks in a vacuum. Well, obviously you can't, but you can get a general idea of it, right? Like Azuralia, when it's not, but like after it was busted, right? Azuralia, during multiple other parts of its career or whatever, has been not good, right? It's not a very strong deck. It does a pretty powerful thing, but it's like it's flimsy. It gets beat up by a lot of stuff, but if you can take it into a field that you know what people are going to play, it can be very, very, very strong. But I would argue that Azuralia is not a good deck. It's an exploitive deck. Original Noxus Elusive was tier 1 in its day. That sounds like something that existed before I was playing the game.
It is time.
I think we just... God, I really want to cast Drum Solo. But, like, I think we just Sky Singer. And these are just, again, like you said, it is just semantics. Like, this is just me saying words. This is not like an actual thing or anything. This is, we're absolutely going to lose to this. Your definition of a good deck seems to rely on going against a large variety of decks. Not really in a vacuum. No, I more look at it like, how powerful is what the deck does, period. And what Azirelia is doing is not incredibly powerful anymore. This deck is not incredibly powerful. What Bar Dex was incredibly powerful. We need to find like stuns and bounces. Oh, Crystal. Oh, Crystal.
You just aren't coming to me. Time to find a muse.
We're at 6, 7. Think Trixie Tentacles could kick the coin out of their hand? Yeah. But let's see. Examples of decks that are very powerful. Vayne Aatrox. What Vayne Aatrox does is incredibly powerful. It's just inherently very strong. It's very consistent. It's just a very good deck, right? I don't have flow enabled, huh? Now I do. Same with Red Gwen. This very strong decks. When I put Ginny, not very powerful. I think Jin Annie is very, very fragile.
Favor finds you.
Just do something like this, right? Just get real annoying with it. Just start here. Why did I not take the pass when my opponent didn't have flow? I wasn't paying attention. I was talking about value and vacuums and stuff. And so I just assumed my opponent had it. Nopify? LOL. Kind of funny. What do we got here? 8? Okay, so I can go like this, and that puts me to 9. No, because I've already hexblitted. Damn. But that's okay, because we could do this, and then we could go like here, here, all sorts of stuff. Okay, we're just chilling. Pass. Okay.
Desire made manifest.
It's about to get nasty up in here.
Heart and mind as one. Ionia speaks through me.
How am I feeling today? A little bit better. I'm getting better. You can probably hear it in my voice. I'm still not feeling like great, but I am feeling better. I want to play Drum Solo. I need to flip Seraphine. I'm going to draw a bunch of cards.
All right, let's jam.
COVID? No. Just like a head cold.
Gotta hear that one again.
Bet. And that's why I wanted to play it. Thoughts on the coin? I think it's really cool. Very excited about it. That's a very, very TLDR.
I fight with my mana. Spirit, my fists.
Wow, free resources is really good. It's almost like if there was a card that maybe cost, I don't know, like a small amount of mana. And then when you cast it, it gave you more resources. Obviously, you had to like earn this mysterious card, right? But then maybe you could stack it and it would give you mana back. Wouldn't that be cool? What do you guys think about that? I could fill the stack here. I just don't care to. You're free to deny as many of these as you want. I don't give a shit. Yep, you got it.
We'll bring
Hey, look, it's Karma.
To Ionia,
she's back.
Whatever the cost, the wish
awaits.
It's over 9.
Skyward Eye. Think of it, the 2 months. Appreciate the prime.
My climb ends.
Kitty cat. Kitty, kitty cat. Looking forward to your vid on the new cards. We'll be making one for each day. I'm going to try to make one for each day. Yeah. Oh, no. What am I going to burn?
Your wish granted.
No! Do you remember when I was playing, do you remember when I was playing that, like, that no champion deck? Where we were playing like Sky Singers and I was trying to draw the whole deck. What if I could make something with that with like the coin? With coins, and I just start like printing money.
Check me
just refill
out.
My mana.
Don't blink or you'll miss
it. It'd be kinda cool. The one where the wind comes milling yourself really slowly? Yeah, that one. Exactly, you get it. Opponent, you are dead. Literally pay to win. Nice, that's kind of funny.
Oh, take your
that's worth a chuckle. Alright, I gotta run to the bathroom. Give me like a couple minutes and then I'm gonna play more of this. I'll be right back. I just start going. Just go to an event, right? Just find out where your locals have events. See if they have a Discord. Let them know that you're coming and that you want to try the game. And they'll hook you up. Spike feeders are great. I need to watch them. Don't they do like mostly Blitz or something? I literally have no idea. Someone told me this. Guys, there are no awkward comments asking to snooze in your unfolded laundry. Yeah, chat, what's up? Huh? You not want to snooze in my unfolded laundry? Oh, they're usually magic? Maybe I'm thinking of different people then.
I fight with my spirit, not my fists.
YouTube. Damn. Spike feeders. Fab. Okay, yeah, no, they do flesh and blood. Yeah, it's like all flesh and blood. Has. It's more fun, MTG or LOR? I mean, I much prefer Runeterra. That's why I'm like here.
We see through all.
We see through all. I'm a stun Zoe. Plus Runeterra is free. That's a pretty big, pretty big mark towards Runeterra.
To the ignorant. Whatever the cost.
We're gonna struggle to activate Flow for a bit.
Blessed by snow.
Gross.
And stars.
Personally prefer MTG. That's why you play LORs this time. Spoken like a true Magic the Gathering player.
Move with purpose.
It's not paper magic, it's paper card games. Yeah, just go play Flesh and Blood, and you'll be like, fuck, man, this is so good.
Who goes there?
Like even playing like One Piece.
This will be a good winter.
It's in paper, and I was like, oh man, this is just nice. Like it just feels good to go and play. I really want to activate Flow. Feels good to go and like play a card game with the boys, right? There are going to be some very large units this game, aren't there? Okay, so we go like this, and then we're going to pop Unworthy Soul Zoe. Well, this might get spooky. But I'm sure it'll be fine. We'll get Serene Sky Singer down.
Blessed by snow oh, and stars. Yeah,
Divine Fine. You know. Not the worst thing ever. Something like that.
Brum.
Holy shit, why is Brum so fucking big? I think I should drum solo. Is there some stuff we could draw that would activate Flow? That'd be kind of nice. Now we're definitely gonna activate
Even
Flow,
at
right?
War, you remain so calm.
Would panicking help, brother?
Player, play Zoe.
Look at this yeah! Look how
sparkly! Get shot! Draw me a card. Yes. Give me Dragonlings.
This would be a good winter.
That's okay. Another karma. All right, so we're gonna need to block, get out Serene Sky Singer, then get out Karma and Seraphine, and then try to win the game.
Forgive me.
What's doing over there?
What's our friends the door? Have you met my shield? Good luck.
Yeah, that's definitely the correct choice. That's not correct. Zoe.
Blessed by snow and stars. Ah, an auspicious season.
You know, I think I'm gonna Hex Obliterator. I think Hex Obliterator is not gonna do anything else for like the rest of the game. I would very much like to activate Flow next turn, but I have like no spells, so. It's looking like we're gonna be chumping with Eye of the Dragons and stuff.
You are safe with Grom.
Oh, my cold's acting up, sorry guys. Trying to breathe.
My past flashes!
Why not kill Seers? That damage has been done. Our opponent is going to have big ass stats for the rest of the game, and there's not anything we can do about it. Alright, we need to draw a draw spell. We have a lot of them left in the deck. We're chumping with basically everything this turn. Huh. Draw spell.
See all.
Then from here, I imagine we should be able to find a win relatively easily.
Meow.
Your attack is obvious.
Meow.
Not dead to Battle Fury.
Blessed by snow.
That's
and
not
stars.
Battle Fury.
A misstep. Oh.
My spirit is an unquenchable fire. Where there is life.
Oh, let's draw Glorious Evolution.
Hope.
That would be glorious.
an auspicious mm-hmm. season.
Yeah. Hell yeah. A little bit of this. A little bit of this. I'm not going to be casting that this game. A little bit of this, and that should be the game.
I'm so good, I surprised myself. Don't blink, or you'll miss me.
What do we got on Sarah Queen? Like 6? 7. Okay. Go find Crystal.
That was great. Now let's really bring it.
Yeah. Most Wanted, definitely one of the cards of all time. Before Drum Solo, I have unironically ran Most Wanted Index. Do you think it's gonna kill him? What do you guys think? Is it close? Are we gonna get there? It's gonna be tough. They won't sponsor me. I don't know why not. They offered me a sponsorship. Like, I reached out to them a couple times and they never got back to me. And then they reached out to me, but it was clearly not because I had reached out to them first. Like, it was like a blanket thing. GG's, man. So they did reach out to me again, and they offered me like a pretty low amount for a sponsorship on YouTube, and I was like, willing to work with you guys if you can like give me something that's worth it. And they're like, nope. Peace out. Product is so good they don't need any promotions. The product's good. It's fine. Like, I like it, obviously. I drink it a lot. I tell you guys about it. But it felt bad to be like, they're just like, yeah, no. Yeah. Like, okay. Cool. That happens a lot with sponsorships. Is there a good R deck? There's not. It happens a lot with sponsorships. They just like send out blanket emails and just lowball everyone. Because enough people, god damn it, enough people will get back to them and take it, even if it's a bad deal. They do Battle Spirits tournament? The community one yesterday, I did that. There's another community one in 1.5 hours that I'm gonna be playing. But no, the big tournament's in Vegas this weekend. Probably just gonna have to cast Drum Solo. Alright, with the new recall, gain a coin card. That'd be nice. I'd be down. How'd you know if it's a good deal without having prior sponsorships? And that's how they get people. That's how they get people. I mean, I've had a lot of sponsorships, so I generally know how much I'm worth. How do you estimate worthy sponsorships? So it's basically like, it depends on your size, how many people are watching, what kind of content you have. Like, if you're making content that like works well with that kind of a thing. That didn't make any sense. Sorry. So like, for me, I'm a card gamer, card game strategy gamer. All right. So if you approach me with a game that's a card game, I can charge more because I say I have a demographic that trusts me when it comes to card games and strategy games. I'm like a large member of this community, whatever, that kind of thing. So I can charge more. I could charge less for something that maybe doesn't quite fit with me, but that's neither really here nor there. A lot of times you just go, X many people are going to be watching this. This sponsorship is going to be seen by X many people. How many hours of work do you need from me? That kind of stuff. And then I'm going to charge more for things I don't want to do. Obviously. Would I promote a sponsorship that's a scam? Not if I think it's a scam. No. Like, what? What'd you expect me to say? You're like, yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Scam away. So I guess we high note this. That way, Unworthy Soul is flowed next turn. They wanted to cast Glorious, but that's okay. I'd like to invest and sponsor your Inverse Funnel operation? Damn, that sounds great. Inverse Funnels are actually my favorite shape.
Can't handle a little cold.
But they pay a lot? Would you do it then?
Hail no. To the king!
Unless they're like, listen, bro, we'll give you $100,000. And then the whole time, I would just be like, don't... Oh, I didn't have Flow Active. Then the whole time, I would just be like, don't fucking do this. I'd be sitting there on like... I'd be sitting there on stream and I'd be like, yeah, guys, it's a great deal. Definitely do this. Just pass. I promote a sponsorship that isn't a scam? Nope, I only promote scams. Only NFTs and crypto gambling here, baby. 9S, Nidus, thank you for the 8 months. Pink region back? Nope. I also really like to promote timeshares. And, what are those called? Those, like, payday loan places? I think that's exactly what they're called, is, like, payday loans. Those are the only things I let sponsor me.
Get ready for a beatdown.
Get ready for an Unworthy Soul. It's a really nice pyramid scheme. You call it Madoff coin. I'll give you 10% of all your income. Damn, that's hella good. Does it by chance come with a bridge? Because I'm looking to buy one. Pass Urino. Bump.
Ha!
Okay, so this means I don't have to worry about FTR next turn. And I can just cast Glorious. That's pretty dope. I do scam you all the time by winning with bad decks. I never said I wouldn't scam you. I said I wouldn't promote scams. Those are different things. Wow, they're really trying to push it, huh? Yeah, I mean, I could die here. Not super likely because I have like this. Also, I think I'll cast Health Pot here just to turn on Flow for Drum Solo in case we're forced to do it. Then we want to get Karma in play as soon as we can because of She Who Wins. Like, it's... What? 1, 2, 3, 8. So they need 4 8 plus spells. So you're not sponsored by HelloFresh, is that because it's a scam? No, I actually kind of like HelloFresh. No, I did them. I've done them previously. I think like HelloFresh Factor. I think those are actually quite solid. Like after I did my Factor sponsorship, my brother did it for another like few months. He really liked it. This bridge for sale. It's a bit rusty on the outside, but fine on the inside. I actually just did a tour of this a few months ago. That's crazy. I didn't know that you owned it. That's insane. In Factor from a sponsorship, it's actually really good. Yeah, it's solid. It's like, so I struggled with it because the food is very creamy. They use a lot of creams. And I'm lactose intolerant. How was the tour? It was very fun. Thank you for asking. Saw a lot of cool stuff. Learned a lot. It was very windy. Oh, I mean, like, whatever, right? Who cares? It can't she who wins me yet.
The spirit gives.
Well, they can, but I'm going to just deny it. Lactose intolerant? Yeah, I hate people who don't have any toes. I am completely... I do not tolerate that shit. Your balance is weird if you don't have them. It grosses me out. Completely intolerant of those that lactose, yeah. And Demacia, yeah, good point. After the tour, would you recommend purchasing it? Yeah, yeah, it was pretty impressive. It's a pretty impressive bridge. It's super flexible on the pricing. Just depends on total savings plus any amount you could scrape together by begging, borrowing, and stealing. Damn, that's a pretty good deal. And I guess I just pass, right? And then I just play leveled karma. And like, what are you gonna do about it?
Heart and mind as one. Ionia speaks through me.
Goes faster. Yep, I'm too quick for you. Let's draw a bunch of cards, right?
We return malevolence.
Do this. We still have deny.
What is gained when we return malevolence?
For like a slow speed atrocity. Gun to my head, I must play an aggro deck for a week until mastery. What deck do I pick? If I have to pick an aggro deck, define aggro. I knew it!
Breathe in, breathe out.
I knew it!
Not all mean well.
For the thrill of battle!
Lights, stage, amp. All right, let's jam.
Yeah.
The crowd writes the songs. I just sing them.
My blade.
I get real gross real quick. I'm just gonna do a little bit of that.
What is gained when we return malevolence?
Push a lot of damage. Early seeking to win via any means by turn 4 to 7. Ooh, man, I don't know. I really just don't
breathe
like
in,
them.
Breathe out.
Oh, I'm about to do a number on this poor lad.
What is gain?
Kitty cat.
Malevolence.
My past flashes.
Are comments getting deleted? A couple of them have been, yeah.
Breathe in,
breathe out. Would panicking help, brother? Just finish him? Nope. We're gonna make our opponent cast Barry and Ice. Oh, they're not even gonna do it. Well, okay. Bop, bop. A little bit of bop, 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 bop.
Bop. What is gained when we return malevolence?
I had Twitch disable your enabled settings to show mod icons. That's kind of annoying.
Get your dancing shoes. Amps live, let's go.
What say you? Uh-huh. No, I'm sure they'll stay low power. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Breathe out.
That one card adds how much damage for us? I cast a one mana spell and it added 14 damage.
What is gained when we return malevolence?
My sound cut off. Hello, hi. There we go. That was weird. Glorious Evolution is fine.
Come on, plenty of time for an encore.
It's fair. It's definitely fair.